Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Everything Science. On today's episode, we'll be discussing two new ways NASA hopes to explore our universe. Recently, researchers have unveiled a steam-powered spacecraft that can explore the universe seemingly indefinitely by making fuel as it goes. Thanks to a partnership between the University of Central Florida, NASA, and private partners, researchers have unveiled a prototype, nicknamed Wine, that can mine water from an asteroid and use it as fuel to power its way across the solar system, potentially changing how we explore the universe. While other research teams have looked into similar steam propulsion systems, Wine is the first to demonstrate full functionality, being able to heat a sample asteroid, collect water, and use it as steam to create lift. According to the developers of this technology, the Wine spacecraft could have about 75 meters per second of thrust, also known as Delta V. While this might not seem like a lot compared to giants like SpaceX's Falcon Heavy coming in at a Delta V of 12,000 meters per second, this would give the small probe enough thrust to jump several kilometers at a time on small worlds like Europa and even reach escape velocity on any planet less than 160 kilometers across. But since the vast majority of asteroids are far smaller than that, a Wine space probe would have the potential to travel indefinitely throughout the solar system, traveling through countless asteroids as it goes, assuming they had water, of course, which, according to recent data, is very common amongst asteroids in our solar system. After Wine is done exploring an asteroid, it could refuel and hop along to its next destination. Part of Wine's beauty is that, even on larger worlds where the craft can't reach escape velocity, it can explore them far more efficiently than a rover ever could by quickly jumping across their surfaces. Keep in mind that rovers like the recently deceased Mars Opportunity rover only explored 42 kilometers in 15 years, so this technology could exponentially increase our ability to explore vast distances on foreign worlds. On a world like Ceres or Europa, Wine would need to ride to the surface as a hitchhiker on a lander with more Delta V to allow for a soft landing. Then, once on the surface, the probe would be able to hop away and explore the rest of the planet. Wine could carry data-collecting instruments itself to conduct experiments on the move, or it could grab samples and bring them back to the lander for a detailed analysis by more sophisticated instruments. Wine could be equipped with a range of data-collecting instruments to analyze things like how much water is available, the presence of organic compounds within the water, and even detect subtle differences in the gravitational field that would hint at the presence of subsurface features like the presence of a hidden underground lake. By not needing to carry a full mission's worth of fuel all the way from Earth, Wine-like spacecraft could drive down the cost of distant planetary exploration. Currently, with a few notable exceptions, space missions have a rigid set of goals and a limited area that can be explored. However, since Wine is designed to never run out of fuel, it can traverse much greater distances, reducing exploration costs by reducing the number of probes needed to be sent to explore any given world. Up next, with its eyes on the future, NASA is testing a new submarine that will search Earth's oceans for undiscovered sea life that they hope will one day look for alien life in the waters of Europa. By some metrics, rocketing to the farthest edges of our solar system is arguably easier than exploring the depths of the oceans. Forget all that fancy rocket science. What really is there to get to Pluto besides putting a fancy camera on a big rocket? Well, it might be a little harder than that, but hundreds of people have gone to space and only three have ever visited the deepest parts of our oceans. Because of the difficulty in getting there, we don't know much about the deepest parts of our oceans, especially the Hadal Zone that's 6 kilometers below the surface, even though it makes up 45% of the world's oceans. But that might be about to change. Researchers from NASA and the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution have teamed up to research, design, and build a new robot to explore the Hadal Zone. The group named their new drone Orpheus, after the mythic Greek hero who dove to the depths of hell and serenaded Hades, the god of the underworld. The research team hopes that their drone too will one day dive deep and find new bottom-dwelling creatures. Currently, the Orpheus drone is about the size of a backyard grill and weighs 600 pounds. Their goal is to one day make a submersible so small and so light that they can shoot it into space to explore other worlds' oceans, and Orpheus is only the first step in that direction. According to the team working on Orpheus, it's the great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandmother of the probe that may one day go to Europa, so there's still a lot of work to be done. The team completed their first untethered autonomous test of the probe in last September in Cape Cod Bay. The probe went 176 meters below the surface, a far cry from the 6,000 meters it needs to go to get into the Hadal Zone, but it was a promising start for the young probe. Because communicating at these depths is near impossible, the probe needs to function fully autonomously, and the research team says there's still a lot of work that needs to be done before the probe can carry out its more complex missions. In the Hadal Zone, where Orpheus will one day travel if all goes to plan, the pressure can reach 16,000 psi. That's more than 1,000 times the pressure you'd experience at sea level. Historically, Earth's oceans aren't a place that NASA has tended to care much about, seeing as how they're on Earth. But the pressure found at the bottom of Earth's oceans is remarkably similar to the pressure found in the oceans of Jupiter's most famous moon, Europa. And since Europa's subsurface oceans are thought to be some of the most likely places that alien life would exist in our solar system, not just in the past, but right now, NASA has a keen interest in jumping in those icy waters. But back here on Earth, the team is convinced they'll find never-before-seen microbes near deep ocean vents that could lead to the development of new antibiotics and new ways of thinking about the necessary conditions for life. But before a mission to Europa becomes possible, scientists first need to learn how to recognize and observe strange forms of life that might exist at such pressures so they don't wind up ignoring an unknown sign of life right in front of their eyes. So who knows, maybe one day Orpheus's descendants will catch a school of alien fish swimming by. Well, that's it for today on Everything Science. If you like this content and are interested in seeing more, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on Everything Science.